of the YouTube community, my name is Thomas and welcome to my countdown to the Eurovision Song Contest 2018. This is the weekly program where I will react to and review all the songs that are going to compete in this year's contest. I do three each week and this week it's time for Russia, the Netherlands and Finland. But before we go on, let's check out the scoreboard from last week. There was absolutely no changes at all on the upper part of my list after last week's entries. Sweden was the best one and ended up taking the 7th spot on my list. I'm gonna take this opportunity to explain a couple of elements on here. At first glance, you might see that 3 of the entries are marked with orange. This is explained at the bottom right, but I'm gonna explain it a bit closer anyways. Some of this year's entries has still not been performed live. That means that I only have a recording and a music video to base my points on. And since I also give away points for the performance, you might understand that I have a problem. I simply can't hand out performance points to a music video. So that's why some of the entries are marked with orange. They have only been given points for the song. So even though Greece only has been given 11 points and are all the way down at number 20, I actually think this is one of the best songs of the year. And the same with Belgium, it still has the potential to reach my top 3, if the live performance is perfect in my eyes. And one thing before we go on. You can see that some of the entries has got the same total score, but they are ranked differently. The exception are Norway and Montenegro, which have the same total score and are also ranked together at number 5. There is actually a quite simple reason for this, in order to make some difference on my list. I rank those with the most points for the song first. So in the case of, for instance, Sweden and Norway, who have the same amount of points, I rank Norway first because I gave that more points for the song. And in the case of Montenegro and Norway, I rank them both at number 5, simply because they got the same amount of points, both for the song and the performance. Quite simple. Last week, in my hunt for the best entry ever in this competition, I sent the 2 first entries into battle to fight for a spot among the last 5. And even though Russia 2016 had a solid lead to begin with, it ended out being Ukraine who took home the victory in this battle. So congratulations to you, Ukraine! You have earned the first spot in the final voting that will take place in the last week before the final. This week's battle are the one between Sweden 1974 and Sweden 2012. So who do you prefer, the post or pre-2000 version of Sweden? Start voting now. Up here. Not in the comment section. Up here. First up today, we have Finland. They had their debut in the contest already in 1961, when they shared the 10th spot with Monaco and the Netherlands. I knew before I did the research for this that Finland were among the least successful countries in the history of the contest. But when I went through all the results from all the finals they have been in, I was in for a couple of surprises. After 51 attempts, they have actually failed to reach the top 10 42 times. They have an average placement of 15th in the contest. And that does not include all the semi-finals they have failed to qualify from, which would actually take that average score lower. I'm not sure if I need to make this worse by saying how many countries who actually took part in a contest during the first years. But as a guy who are from Norway, I kind of feel a need to go on with a more successful part of their history now. Because in 2006, they sent what went on to become one of the most legendary acts ever, when they sent the heavy metal band Lordi to represent them. Lordi crushed the other entries and won the contest with a record-breaking 292 points. A record that stood for 3 years before it was beaten by Norway. And for the friendship of our countries, I can't see the reason to talk about how they did after they won the contest. Finland, let's see if you have discovered the formula of success when you are sending monsters back to the contest. Finland, let's see what you have for us. Finland, Finland. Okay, that was special. Try to figure out what type of song this is. What I can say about this already now is that this is the type of song that needs some time to grow, I think. It doesn't sound that strong to me now, because I haven't ever heard it before. It has a melody that needs some work in the head. In the listener's head, yeah. But I'm gonna give it to them for the stage. The stage was awesome. I can also hear that it's really trying hard to be better than it really is. Like it believes it's better than it is. Okay, yeah. Not one of my favorites at all. It has all the elements of a song that has been overused even in Eurovision. And I also don't think it was any good elements in here that made justice to that decision, if you know what I mean. So for me, this was kind of below mediocre. And that goes for both the song and her voice. But the staging was cool. The staging was awesome. So it adds some performance points. But it's pretty low anyways because of her voice, which I didn't like. So the song itself, I'm gonna give 5 points to that. Just below mediocre. And the performance, can we say that the performance is just above mediocre? So if I give the performance a 7? No, actually it's not good enough to be 7. I give 6 to the performance. Because the voice wasn't good enough, even though the show, the staging was pretty cool. So that means I give 11 points in total to Finland. Next up, we have another legendary country in Eurovision, the Netherlands. With 2 victories, they were kings of the contest in the 50s. But they did have 2 more victories after that. The first one in 1969, when they had to share it with Spain, United Kingdom and France. And the second and last was in 1975, when they won with what I dare to say is their most famous song so far. Ding dong! After the introduction of the semi-finals, they have sadly done extremely poorly in the contest. After they ended at number 20 in 2004, they didn't even qualify before 2013, when their 90s rock star Anouk, which I was a major fan of back in the 90s, took home their best placement since 1999 with the song Burn. She ended at number 9. But the year after, in 2014, they almost made it all the way to the top. They ended second with the country duet Calm After the Storm. And this year it looks like the Netherlands are attempting to copy the success they had that year. Because rumor has it, they are yet again sending a country song. Will they succeed? Let's find out. The Netherlands, let's see what you have for us. Yeah, sounds awesome right away. He really has that hillbilly voice, doesn't he? It's my type of country. I'm not that into country. But this is my type of country. This is country for men. Yeah. Yeah. But he's sure got a badass voice. He's really got a badass voice. Nice solo as well. Yeah, I can see the women also sweating in their underpants. Huh. Yeah! But I'm super confused. Was this a live event? Or was this a recording? It was done live. But did they do like San Marino, add the recorded voice on top of it? I don't think they did. I think actually that's the way the guy sounds. And if that's the case, he has a brilliant voice. He has an extremely good voice. I loved it. And one other thing I liked about this song was that it had so many elements. It sounded longer than it was, but nothing in here felt rushed. It felt like a song that was like 4 or 5 minutes long, but it was only 3 minutes. So it was compressed without getting the feeling of being compressed. I actually think I'm gonna give 11 points for the song because I really, really enjoyed this song. And when it comes to the performance, he had an amazing voice. In fact, this sounded so great that I'm not 100% sure that everything is in here was authentic live. But I'm thinking about giving it a 10 anyways, because I'm not that sure. But I believe also that he will deliver in Lisboa. I think he actually have this great voice that you heard here now. So I'm gonna give him 10 points for the performance as well. Which means I give out 21 points to the Netherlands. Great job. The last country up today are Russia. Russia had their debut in 1994 and took part in the contest 3 times in the 90s without being too successful. But in the 2000s, the story is rewritten. They have qualified for every single final and have reached the top 5 9 times out of 14 attempts. And that's pretty impressive. And in 2008, they won the contest when Dima Bilan performed the song Believe. A song that was produced by the producer, the rapper, the singer, the songwriter, the DJ, the legendary Timbaland. Last year, Russia was struck by controversy when their artist Yulia Samoilova was banned from entering Ukraine, who happened to host the contest that year. All the attempts to reverse this decision failed, and Russia had no other option than to withdraw from the contest. But Yulia has gotten a second chance to represent Russia this year, and let's hope everything goes smoothly for her this time. The song is called I Won't Break. Russia, let's see what you have for us. Julia! What do you have for us, Julia? And this is the music video, yeah. No longer in the dark. My castle in the sand. Snow made of stone and rock. Sounds like a ballad. The memory on you. But I'm not sure if it is. Yeah, I like this type of voice. Kinda sounds like an Indian. I wonder if this song is about her own story. She has this muscle disease, so she is in a wheelchair. But I'm gonna be honest and say that this is not the most exciting song I have heard so far this year. Yeah, wow, sudden end. Not the most exciting song this year, but there was elements I really enjoyed in here. I really enjoyed her high tones. When I said she sounded like an Indian, when the Indians sing, they go really up, and she had, there was something in her voice that sounded like that. Those high Indian voices. If I'm gonna compare this song to the other entries we have seen from the Russia the last years, that have pretty much made it into the top 5, I believe this will make it through the fire semifinals. But I'm not sure if this will make it into the top 10. I'm not a top 15 either. I believe this will be a top 20. But if I'm gonna guess, I believe we will see Russia at number 17 maybe this year. Around 17 somewhere. I'm gonna give 6 points for the song. Almost 7 for me, but I'm landing on 6 points. And since this was a music video, I know there is a clip from the pre-show in Moscow, but I have heard that was so terrible. And only shot from one angle also. I did some sneak peeks into the video, and yeah, it was only shot from one angle and wasn't a representative version of her doing it live, I think. So I landed on doing the music video, So there are no performance points to Julia from me. Which means Roshia end up with 6 points from me. That's it for me today. Remember to vote for your favorite entry among Sweden 74 and Sweden 2012. The reason I pointed was that you can find the voting system here, right here, I think. And also, give a like to this video if you liked it. But most important for me, subscribe to my channel if you like this video. Okay? Please do that. Next week, I will do the songs from Australia, Cyprus, and Ireland. And until then, take care of yourself and have a nice week. Bye.